All right. So here we are in the field. Well, hold on, let me go back. There's Kay. Kafka! Hey! Gotta get a obligatory Kafka shot. Alright. Alright, now, so I'm walking up here like this. Oh. A divergence in the path. A split. I guess I'll have to come back like in November or October and have like a Robert Frost moment here, you know, and do like a, you know, have a reading sort of thing. But, you know, maybe not.
Now listen, Julie baby, it ain't natural for you to cry in the midnight.
I don't know. Oh,
it ain't natural for you to cry.
Have you looked around? Have you seen this? Look at this.
When
look.
The midnight. Whoop. Pew.
All this. This is my backyard. This is our backyard.
For the break of dawn.
This is mine and Shannon and Kafka's backyard. But really, you know, if you have to, if you want to put a finer point on it, isn't, you know. Hold on, let me flip this thing around so I can see. Oop, hit the wrong button. The country is my backyard. America is my backyard. Moreover, the planet is my backyard. Moreover, the universe is my backyard. Actually, now that I think about it, everything is my backyard. I got a pretty damn big backyard. I like my yard. I don't like mowing my yard. I don't like mowing the universe. I don't see the need in that. My dad used to want it. He used to want me to mow the universe all the time. And you know, he would say, you know, when I was old enough to run a lawnmower, and my dad would trust me to run it without wrecking it. Even though, well, obviously kids wreck lawnmowers, but when he felt comfortable enough to let me operate the lawnmower, I loved mowing. Actually, I still kind of do, especially when I worked at the golf course. They got the best lawnmowers there. But, yeah, he would say he'd bring a lawnmower home, and I'd put it together, and he'd flip me a 20, and, you know, he'd say, go mow the universe. And I'm like, who am I to mow a universe? I don't. Well, what's the point of that? What it gets accomplished? I mean, in the grand scheme of things, you know, does that serve a purpose, mowing the universe? To cut down the overgrowth. Well, I mean, it does serve a purpose. Hold on a second. I'm going to shorten up the stick here so I can carry it better. Mowing the universe. I don't know. I think the universe pretty much mows itself. Don't things really pretty much take care of themselves? Wasn't everything pretty much already going to do whatever it was going to do before we got here? So, I guess that would lead people to assume that whatever, you know. I don't know, it goes back to yard work. It's all about the yard work. It's more about, I think it's about, you know, trying to find order and control in a place that doesn't allow order and control. It's trying to define something. You know, you mow a yard because you want it to look a certain way. Well, if you want something to look a certain way, then you are defining it. I mean, that is that thing. Instead of it just being you have controlled it. You have veered its natural path, and you have taken it in another direction. A direction where you imposed your will upon that thing. So, do I want to mow the universe? No. I have. I've never really regretted doing it. You know, I always go back to the old, I hate to be lame and this is going to sound really weak, but, the idea that, in, the movie Men in Black, the marble bag concept, I'm a huge proponent of the, galactic marble bag concept. I haven't really gotten into Douglas Adams, but I'm going, I've been wanting to get into reading him because I have a feeling, I mean, I saw the movie that they made on the Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy, and so I think that that's definitely something. I think he's of my ilk. I think we think similarly in a, you know, quasi political, religious, socio, psycho, matter-of-factly, physics, science, I don't know, it's just kind of, you know, you gotta kind of take it all in, all together, all the disciplines. You can't just adhere to one discipline. You gotta take in all the disciplines. And then the next step is to go to the garage, get the gas can, take the cap off the gas can, pour the gas in the mower, and pull the crank, and, you know, walk around as your two-cycle or two-stroke Briggs and Stratton. Whatever it's called, there's a name for that kind of engine. Pumps away and spins this metal bar laterally and cuts the grass. You know, there's a lot to be said for cutting grass. I guess I'm done.